Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 15 Beta 6 has even more changes and features than I mentioned in the initial video of iOS 15 Beta 6 What's New. And so I wanted to go over all of those differences that have been found since. Now, before I talk about that, on the weekends, usually on Sunday or so, I do a video where I talk about the overall stability, performance, and whether or not you should install the beta if you haven't already. So I gather all of the information based off my own use. I have it installed on my 12 Pro Max, which is my main device, and I also run a YouTube community poll. And so based off the poll, I gather all of that information and try and paint the most accurate picture for you to let you know how it's going. Now, if you haven't voted on this poll, it's on the Zolotech YouTube channel, and then you tap on community. You can do that in a web browser as well. Unfortunately, you can't get to it on the YouTube app on iPad, so you'll have to use the web browser. But if you vote and then comment, this was the last one for beta 5 with 40,000 votes and 460 comments. I take that information and try and paint the most accurate picture. So if you haven't voted and commented yet, it's always appreciated to get all of the information we can to help everyone that's using the beta. So be sure to do that if you haven't already. Also with YouTube, many people have been asking me, where is picture in picture? Since YouTube started rolling this out, I showed how it worked in a different video. And for many people, it shows up and then it disappears. And that's happened on some of my phones as well, depending on which one you're on. So YouTube has said they're still rolling it out. Not everyone has it yet. And unfortunately, it's in the United States under those that have been using the paid version. So you're using YouTube Premium, and generally in the United States, you'll have picture-in-picture built in. However, not everyone is seeing that. I've seen other creators that have had it and then it disappeared. So hopefully it rolls out soon. I heard in a podcast that it may be due to legal issues. So hopefully they just get that out here pretty soon. It seems well past due and we should have it soon. And finally, before we go over new features, many people have been concerned about Apple's new CSAM scanning using the photo app and encrypted end-to-end encryption to sort of keep it secure, but also scan photos for images that really shouldn't belong there. But this could be abused, and that's the major concern. And there's a recent article that was posted by professors at Princeton University that said they really think Apple should not do this, as they've tested it themselves using their own sort of technology, and they call it dangerous. So it's hard to say if Apple will continue to push this with iOS 15 or delay it due to many concerns. It wouldn't surprise me if they delay it, since many people are very concerned about the technology having implications in the future. So I would like to see them delay it and maybe test it a little bit further, maybe with some professors that have actually tried this out at Princeton, for example. So maybe we'll see them change their strategy with it. We'll have to wait and see. Now, the first thing is a new change that has to do with widgets. Now, there's a screen time widget, and the screen time widget, while I haven't really used screen time very much, has been updated with your own photo. So whatever photo is attached to your iCloud account, it will now have your photo in the upper left. And so that's a little bit of a change as well. Now, also, if you're in the Photos app, there's been a new discovery. Now, this could have been there with Beta 5 as well, but it's an iOS 15 feature I haven't seen mentioned anywhere else. As if you're in your Photos app and then you go to People, you can now pin people as a favorite. So if I go into Photos, and under Photos, you'll see a little heart next to the side here. If you tap on it, you'll see it pins to the top, and that's me. So it's pinning me to the top, and it's just a little bit of an update and a change. So that's something that's a little bit new. Now, I talked about Safari being updated and Apple keeps changing this, and I really do like this new version. I wasn't so sure I would, but right now, after using it for a few days, I think it's one of the better implementations we've seen with the betas, but there's a couple changes with that as well. One thing is, if you swipe up from the bottom, you can instantly go into your tabs. So you can do that by tapping the tab button, but you can just swipe up as well. So swipe up anywhere on the bottom and you'll go into your tabs. Also, if you download something, they've brought the download icon back. So if you press and hold on this image and then download linked file as, you'll see the little download button just sort of appeared and then filled in once it was downloaded. Then you can tap on this and see your downloads. So that's something that's a little bit different in iOS 15 Beta 6. Also, a user on Reddit found new real-world walking directions on their phone. Now, this is a newer feature where it uses your camera and overlays augmented reality to help you walk to your destination. And they actually got a little splash screen when they tried to enter an address. I have not been able to replicate this, and their photo actually shows wondering which way to walk, view directions in the real world. And this is something that could be coming soon. And if you have this icon, it will show up and you'll be able to get those walking directions. So hopefully we see that soon in more cities. I tried directions even in this area and was not able to duplicate it, but maybe more of you are seeing it, and I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. Now, something that Apple has removed, unfortunately, is screen sharing in FaceTime. Now, I talked about how they removed SharePlay, but if we go into FaceTime and I'll call myself. Now, within FaceTime, you can see there's no longer an option to share your screen. Before, we had the option at the top, and we can no longer do that. We can change the camera, the microphone, the speaker, and message, but we can no longer share the screen itself. So this is something that may be added later with SharePlay, but hopefully they bring back with maybe beta 7. So that's something that's a little unfortunate, as it seemed to work really well. Also within FaceTime, something I haven't mentioned before is if you're in the camera and then you spin it around to the back camera, we now have some zoom options. So those were not there in earlier betas. We now have zoom options here. So that's something I never mentioned in previous videos. Now, another thing Apple changed or brought back with beta 6 that was not there with beta 5 is if you go into shortcuts and you go to automations and you have an Apple Watch, you can now change your watch face based on the time of day. Now, this is something that was there previously, but was gone in beta 5. Now it's back. And if you want to set this up, you can set it up based on a time of day, and then you can set the watch face based on what you have as far as watch face is set up. So I have Gradient, Infograph Modular, and Stripes. So this is Infograph Modular with Lumi installed. And then I have Stripes, and I have this one as well, the Gradient. So you have those options. Once you set up a different one, whether it's photos or not, you can add those as well. But you can change throughout the day. Maybe when you get home, have it switch around the time you would get home, something like that. So you can set up that automation now. It wasn't available in earlier betas, so it's been brought back. Now, another thing that's new is if you're using an app such as Truecaller, there's some options in messages. So in messages, first you need to have an option turned on. So if you go to your settings and then go to messages and then scroll down, you'll need to make sure first that you have filter on unknown senders turned on. If you have that turned on, you'll see it says sort messages from people who are not in your contacts into a separate list. If you have that feature turned on and then you have a separate app that sort of screens calls such as Truecaller, there's some new options when you go into that list. So if you go into messages, you'll see you can sort between all messages, known senders, and unknown senders. However, if you have another app installed, it looks a little different. And so thanks to Nicole for sending this along, and you'll see that it has filtered by Truecaller. You have transactions, promotions, and then junk. So if you have an app that's integrated directly into this, you'll have additional options here. So I think that's really nice. People have never reported this before, to me at least, and I haven't seen it posted elsewhere, and it seems to be new in beta 6. But let me know if you've had this before as well. Now, there's another feature that's been updated in iOS 15 in general, but again, I haven't seen this mentioned elsewhere, and that's if you're in the camera and maybe you're using night mode. So let me turn off the lights so night mode shows up. And once night mode shows up in the upper left here, tap on it. If you have a phone with night mode, scroll all the way to the back here and it says off. You can permanently shut off night mode if you don't like to use it. So maybe you just want to capture the actual dark of night, you can do that. And so if we go out, maybe go back in, and then go back to night mode, you'll see that it has a little line through it as though it's off, just like RAW is currently. Or we can turn it back on. So now you have the option to control that where you didn't before in earlier versions. So that's something that's new with iOS 15 in general that I thought I'd share that I hadn't before. Now, something people have said that is new, but I haven't really seen much of an update with it, is Spotlight Search. Spotlight Search seems to be bringing more accurate information now, such as shortcuts and maps and Apple Wallet. And you can see all of the different things here, but most people are saying it's working better. You could see show more apps and it will list all those apps. So I don't see a change here, but at least it's working a little bit better. So that's everything with iOS 15 beta 6. As we get closer to a final release, Apple sort of tightens up everything that works well, and then unfortunately pushes some new features to later updates, such as SharePlay. We've seen them do this before, and now they're they're doing that with SharePlay. So hopefully it will be with 15.1 maybe, but I'm looking forward to the next beta to see maybe if they add screen sharing back into FaceTime or something along those lines. Now, if you found anything else, some people did mention that maybe the font was different in the folders. I was not able to find any difference there with beta 5, but if you found anything else, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And of course, I'm looking for iOS 15 beta 7 to come out sometime around next Tuesday. It seems like we're on a weekly schedule at this point, so I would expect it around that time. And hopefully we'll see betas every week until the release candidate and then the final release sometime in mid to late September. Based on what we're seeing now and the stability, I would expect maybe mid-September. However, we do expect an Apple event sometime in there where they'll show off iPhone 13. And then usually around that week or so, we'll get the time of the iOS 15 release. So that along with iPadOS 15 and more. So I'm looking forward to that. But again, if you found anything else new, let me know in the comments below. And if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.